Hello everybody, my name is Wilder, and I have a lot of new info to share with you about Story of Seasons Pioneers of Olivetown. But before we get into all the new info, I want to show you the premium edition of the game that was announced, so let's take a look at that together. Now something really interesting is that the North American version of the premium edition and the European version, they're totally different. I know they're usually different anyway, but these are actually different enough that I wanted to point it out, cause low-key I'm kinda jealous of Europe right now, not gonna lie. Anyway, let's take a look at the North American version here first. With this premium edition, you'll be getting the base game, of course, this absolutely adorable buffalo plushie. He's another pocket plush, by the way, just like the strawberry cow was from Mineral Town, so he's pretty small and cute. If you got the strawberry cow from Mineral Town, then you'll know the size of this one. You'll also be getting this beautiful cloth poster, which has art from the game. This is actually the first piece of artwork we got to see when the game was announced, and I still really love it. It looks so nice, and I'm really glad they put it on a poster. A cloth one, no less. So that's super cool. And finally, of course, you get the box that everything comes in, which has some amazing art on it itself, like the Room Factory boxes. All in all, you get a pretty good package here. This is pretty nice. Now the base game, just the game itself, will cost $49.99 US. That's $69.99 for my fellow Canadians. And the special edition, which is shown off here, will cost the full price of $59.99 US or $79.99 Canadian. For just 10 extra dollars, you get quite a bit of stuff here in this box, so it really is a nice deal. However, no matter how nice this deal is, I'd like to show you the European version because they got hooked up with their special edition. Check this out. Now first, as for the buffalo plushie, for Europe, if you buy the standard edition of the game from retailers, you'll receive the plushie along with the game. I don't know if it'll come with this special edition, so you'll have to find that out for yourself, but at least the base game comes with it, so that's good. But if you're getting this version, then you will get the base game along with a poster here as well. But it has different art on it than the North American version, which I also think is really pretty. I don't know if it's a cloth poster though, it didn't say. But here are the really cool perks. First, you get this cute little notebook with all the characters on it, all the marriage candidates. If you're someone who likes writing down notes for Story of Seasons games, this will be a nice little notebook to write down tips and tricks so you don't have to look them up all the time. This notebook is super cute, but you also get 10 trading cards of all the marriage candidates in the game. Why couldn't we have gotten these cards here in North America as well? They're so cool. I love trading cards, by the way. I would have framed these. They look so awesome. I really want them. This is why I'm jealous of Europe's special edition, by the way. These cards are cool. I'm sorry that I don't know EU-UK prices too well. This'll cost the same as it does in North America for you guys. The special edition will cost £54.99 in pounds, or £59.99 in euros, depending on where you live. Hope I got those prices right. If you take 10 off of that price, then the standard edition will be $44.99, or $49.99. You guys are getting, in my opinion, a better deal than us here in North America because the prices are the same, but you also get the plushie with the base game, which is awesome. Plus those trading cards and the notebook. That is so cool. I'm really jealous. Anyway, there are the special editions, no pre-order dates yet, but let me know if you're getting them. However, now we have a ton of new information about this game that came out recently, so let's check that out. First off, we have information about crafting in Olivetown. There will be a crafting system, which makes sense of course, because of the fact that we have to decorate our entire farm. You'll use the materials you get from cutting trees and mining to craft certain items and decorations. But something really interesting is that you'll be able to throw materials into makers to get all new materials to craft with. So makers are returning again to Story of Seasons. Next are what's been referred to as special places. Apparently we'll be able to travel to special places, such as volcanoes, and get this, above the sky. What? Above the sky? What is this, Rune Factory? Like, if this were Rune Factory, I'd be like, oh yeah, volcanoes. You know, new dungeon, new bosses, this'll be awesome. But it's still Story of Seasons, so I assume maybe materials? What about above the sky, though? That's the one that's crazy to me. In fact, check this out. There were a bunch of new screenshots shown off as well, which we'll get to in a minute. But take a look at these two in particular. The first one shows a huge beanstalk that grows past the clouds, and the second one shows that it leads to a field. Maybe the volcanoes will have a field too, and this will be a mechanic that works like the greenhouses did in old games, where each field will be a different season all year long. You think? I don't know, but this is pretty cool. I like it. I can't wait to see what other interesting areas we'll be able to go to as well, because if it is the four seasons, there should be two left. I love the beanstalk, by the way. I think it's pretty goofy looking. I don't know, it just looks funny to me. But let's take it back down to Olive Town itself, because we learned quite a bit about Olive Town as well. So Olive Town is a small harbor town with little to no tourism. But by doing requests for the villagers, over time, Olive Town will grow and attract more people and even new shops that'll move in. Now this one is a really cool bit of information because it reminds me a ton of A New Beginning. In fact, with the crafting and decorating mechanics, and now the town building, this game is really reminding me of Harvest Moon A New Beginning. I adore that game, by the way, even if it had like the slowest start ever. I love that game. So the fact that this is looking pretty similar makes me really, really happy. Honestly, this is turning out to be better than I thought it would. This game looks really cool. Anyway, lastly, we got introduced to 6 new villagers. I'm gonna rapid fire them off here, starting with Misaki. She's a mysterious bistro manager. Next is Clemens, he's a friendly tool shop manager. Then we have Angela, she's the general store manager. And actually, if you remember Jack from the marriage candidate video, card in the top right corner, if you haven't seen it, this is his mom, so that's cool. Next is Nguyen, I hope I pronounced that right. Nguyen is the old man who runs the flower shop where Rin works. She's also from the previous video. Then we have Norman, a faint-hearted grocery manager. And last but certainly not least, we have Karina, an independent hair/makeup artist. These new villagers are really cool. They all look interesting, but based on the comments of my last video, I'll bet there are quite a few of you who want some of these villagers to be marriage candidates. Not gonna lie, I would too. Angela and Karina are 2 of them. They look awesome. Let me know what you think about that in the comments. But last and certainly not least, let's look at some of the new screenshots we got of the game. Here they are. Some of them are showing off quite a bit of Olive Town. There's one of you riding your horse, which looks cool. There's one that appears to be of a festival type mini game, which is really exciting. And then there's one that shows these little creatures in the volcano. Apparently they're called Kolopon. That's what they are. This shows that magic is coming back to Story of Seasons a little bit. Maybe these guys will work like the Harvest Sprites. I don't know. This is interesting though. They look cool. They're kind of cute. They're a little funny looking though, I'm gonna be honest. But yeah, we got a bunch of screenshots. They look really awesome. And I gotta say, this game, the more I learn about it, the more I really just wanna play it. I started off not being super excited about it, but the more I hear, the more it seems to be like a new beginning, in its structure anyway, you know? And I really can't wait to try it out myself. While I do still have problems with it so far, I'm getting more and more excited for it as time goes on, which is a good thing. And remember, it's coming out soon as well. The release date is March 23rd for North America and Europe, so we really don't have to wait that much longer. Also, if you're someone who likes to get the Japanese version of games, then this will be coming out just a bit earlier for Japan on February 25th. Those dates are really close together, not like the Mineral Town remake. So hopefully soon we can have like worldwide releases for Story of Seasons maybe? We can get it all at the same time? That'd be cool, I'd love that. But that's gonna be it from me today. What do you think about all the new info we got? Are you going to be getting the premium edition of this game? Let me know in those comments down below. Don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed this video. All links are down in the description along with the names of my wonderful, amazing patrons. Thank you all so much for watching, and as always, I will see you in the next one.